Hello guys, welcome back to the part 2 of the truffle tutorial series. So in this tutorial, we'll talk about truffle and how to initialize, how to create new truffle projects and the project structure of a truffle project. So the first things first, well, let me just increase the size of this a little. So right now I have my terminal opened or my command prompt opened. And the first thing is to do, we've already installed truffle. And if you've not watched the video or you don't know how to go about it, you should go watch the video right now so that you can follow up this tutorial. So with truffle already installed, we need to create a folder where our project will live in. So I'll go to my documents and I'll make a directory here. Let's call this truffle. Yeah, and if you check here, And if you check here, yeah, we can see there are no files, there are no directories here. So right now we've created our folder. We need to open it with a text editor. You can make use of any text editor whatsoever, but I'll be using the VS Code. I love Visual Studio Code. If you're using Atom or any code editor, it's okay, it's fine. But I'll be using the Visual Studio Code. So I want to open this folder in the Visual Studio Code. I hit enter. So if you go over here to the terminal tab, you can see a new terminal. Remember in the previous video, we installed Truffle, we installed it globally, meaning we can call it from anywhere on the system. To create a truffle project, we just need to run truffle init. So once we do truffle init, and to create a contract, we can simply run truffle create contract and the contract's name. To create a test, we can run truffle create test and a test name. So now we have to talk about the project structure, the directory of a truffle project. So we can see now we have the contract here. So the contract is basically a folder where the contract, any contract you want to create, this is where they live. You just have to create a new file, name it whatever, and the extension should be .so, which is an extension for Solidity files. So we have the migrations. The migrations are JavaScript files which help to deploy your contracts. And now we have the test folder. The test folder is where you write your tests. If you want to test your smart contracts, this is where you write your tests and you can test the smart contracts. And we have the truffle config, which we'll talk about later in this video. But the truffle config is the configuration of this project. By the way, if you're new to this channel, please subscribe to this channel if you love the video so far. And in case you don't know me, I'm Isaac Frank. And on this channel, I talk about blockchain and programming in general. So if it's something that interests you, hit the like button and subscribe to this channel right now. So back to this video. To create a contract, we can simply go to the contract folder and create a new file. Or we can make use of this truffle command, which was listed here for us to create a contract. So right here, I'll run truffle create contract, and the contract name, you just say test. So once we check this folder, we should have a test.so here. I don't need the constructor here because I don't need anything to do with the constructor. So we can just create a simple calculation and add. So this adds two numbers. So here we can say you int 256 A and you int 256 B. And it's a public function and it's a view function. And what else? You should return uint 256, which will call sum, and sum should equal a plus b. This actually is not security proved because underflow and overflow can happen here. So what we're doing here is sum is equal to a plus b, which is a sum, but we can't see any return statement. This is because right in the returns statement, we specify the variable's name. So once we assign this to the variable, it knows automatically that it should return this. So I know I'm deviating a little bit into Solidity tutorials. Just for fun, let's create a sub. And again, this is not security approved. So as you can see, creating contracts is that easy. Now we'll come to the migration part of this truffle. And the migration, like I said earlier, is where you create your JavaScript files for deployment purposes. So here we can create another file for the deployment of the test contract. I'll be using the command line, so I'll just move into, just echo empty string into the migrations, and we'll call this 2_deploy_test.js. So we just created a new file here. The reason I gave this numbering to is because the first migration to be deployed will be the initial migrations, and the second will be the deploy test. So this is a way to stage the migrations. This initial migration, so this basically deploys the migration contract. Now we can see here we have an active file that require, and now we can see a function. This function receives three parameters. The first is the deployer, the second is the network, I think, and the third is the address. or the second is the address, and the third is the network. So the deployer is responsible for deploying contracts. So you can see here we do deployer.deploy, and we're deploying the migration, the artifacts which we required. So I'll just copy this to the test migration and just make changes where it needs to be. So here I'll copy this and deploy. I paste this here. Now I'll change this to test. And this, since we are not looking for the migration, we're looking for the test contract. I'll change this to test too. And right here, I'll change this to test. So now we're deploying the test contract. Then we come over to the test folder. The test folder is the folder that holds all tests for a contract. We can see a scaffold here to create a test folder. Drop through, create test, or call this contract test. As you can see, we have a contract test. And if we look at this, we should see a scaffold of how the test should be. So Drop uses Chai, which is a testing library, a testing JavaScript library to test JavaScript files. So it imports all the functions of Chai into a test file. So we don't need to import this asset. We should be able to access the expect function from Chai. So where we can compare two variables or stuff. So now we know how to create a contract. We know the contract lives in the contract directory. We know the migration lives in the migration directory, and we know the test lives in the test directory, and you can create this using commands from Truffle. But there's a file we've not talked about, and that is the Truffle config. Some places, especially in the Linux-based system, you'll be seeing Truffle.js. But on Windows, if it's called Truffle.js and you try running a Truffle command, Windows assumes you are using the file and tries to use the file. So which is why we use Truffle config.js. But if we go into the Truffle config file, we can see this is basically the configuration of a Truffle project. So this holds all keys and values of a Truffle project. We can deploy to many using Infura and this library. We'll go deep into this when we start deploying. But right now, I just want to give you a rundown of Truffle projects. So we can see here, we can do all this fun stuff. And we can see networks. So these networks are the networks we want available for our project, like the Rustin network, the Covert network, Ganache, Ethereum network, the Mainnet, BSC, BS test. So this is where we specify all networks, Polygon and the rest. So we can see we have a development network, and we have the advanced, and we have a Rustin test network. So it's already created for us. We have a Rustin test network. And what else we have here? Those are the basic network we have. We can add more, and we can remove whatever we don't need here. We have a mocha, which is for test. We have the settings too. We can specify a test, a timeout for this, and some other variables we can specify for this. And we have a compiler. So this is the part of your project that tells Truffle what compiler to use, what version of Solidity to make use of. When you install Truffle, it installs a Solidity compiler. So the default it makes use of is whatever version it installed with it. So we can specify the version here. We can tell Truffle, no, we need you to use a specific version, let's say 4.1, and Truffle makes use of this version. And this is the settings. We can turn on optimizer, which is not hard. Basically, we just need to change this to true and how many runs we wish to run for the optimizer. Okay, this is my first time seeing this DB property. It's a new thing, I think, because I've not been seeing it since I've working with Truffle. Maybe I've been using an updated version of Truffle, but this is my first time seeing this. So this is basically a Truffle configuration file that holds all configuration of your Truffle project. So in summary, we have the contract folder, which shows our contracts. We have the migration folder, which shows our migration, meaning our JavaScript deployment files. Then we have the test, which shows our test files, which is also JavaScript or TypeScript, whatever you want to use to run your test. Even Solidity, you can run Solidity test here. So we have the test folder for test. And we have the config folder that holds our configuration. So that's all for this video on the rundown of Truffle directory. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up. And if you're new to this channel and you haven't subscribed yet, but you love our content, please hit the subscribe button right now. In the next video, we'll talk about compiling and migrating contracts. So deploying contracts and compiling smart contracts with Truffle. Thank you guys for watching, and hopefully I see you guys in the next video.